Ali Zerbiak stayed right with him. Ooh, you know, on second look, I'm not so sure.
Not so sure. I disagree with Pierce and Coach Van Gundy. That's good defense by Wow.
I stand corrected. Hey, when you're wrong, you can either fight it or say you were wrong.
Kenny Merrill, we apologize as West knocks down the shot.
I'm not going that far. I'm not apologizing to a ref. I was wrong. That's as far as I'm willing to take it.
Meanwhile, Galante West, who again, you watch his game, not the prettiest of game, doesn't have numbers that blow you away, but he has been very effective as Pierce opens up exactly the way the Celtics would have loved. A couple of good jump shots early.
Well, one of the things that LeBron James has trouble with is screens on the ball. He's such a big body, it's hard to negotiate those screens as he knocks it in, which allows Pierce some separation.
And we talk so much about the Celtic defense. The Cavs defense in this series has been equally as impressive, if not more, at some point. Pierce, very aggressive early, not that time.
But it's been all jump shots, Mike. They've got to find Kevin Garnett in the post so they can get at the basket some.
West goes right at Rondo, his former teammate, but he used his right arm. And an offensive foul on Delonte West. Well, the Cavs will get back on defense where they have been just superb. Look at those numbers, especially from three-point shooting.
The Celtics average 100 points in the regular season. And I'm surprised. Cleveland's a good, solid defensive team, but not a great one, Mark. I'm surprised Boston's had so much trouble scoring.
And they've done a great job of realizing how the Celtics can hurt them and taking them out of those things.
Most notably, Ray Allen and Paul Pierce. Zerbiak now on Pierce on his possession. Garnett, good wide open shot.
I really like the aggressiveness of Paul Pierce early. Missed the last jump shot, but continues to look to make plays. That time puts it on the floor and finds Garnett.
The teams are combined 5 or 8. It's an offensive explosion on what has been so far one of the lowest scoring playoff series in the history of the NBA. Zerbiak misses. Garnett, tough rebound in traffic. Of course, as we mentioned, Celtics with the Game 7 experience against Atlanta. Garnett also had a big Game 7 experience when he was with Minnesota, had one of the best games of his career. Gets inside, feeding Perkins. Ilgauskas grabbed his jersey, and Perkins still able to put it in.
You know, see what the Cavs are doing. They're trapping pick-and-roll situations, whether it be Pierce or Allen. Those guys have to get rid of the basketball and trust that other guys will make plays. That time it was KG.
Ilgauskas. Can't get it to fall. Garnett, yet another rebound already with 4. Pierce to Rondo. Rondo on the drive. Nice feed to Perkins, blocked by Zerbiak for the foul. Rajon Rondo getting inside with a beautiful dish.
Oh, here's what we're talking about in pick-and-roll situations, whether it be Allen or Pierce with the basketball. They trap those guys. You got to delay, get rid of the basketball, and force the next guy to make the play. KG does that, puts the ball on the floor, and delivers it to Perkins.
Now Perkins, the young man, 23 years old. This is his fifth year in the league. He's a veteran already, right from high school in Texas to the NBA. And both Perkins and Rondo last year, of course, played for a bad team that won 24 games. Young guys are kind of struggling, had their ups and downs, and now they're in the starting lineup for a team that's competing for a championship. And they just need good, solid play from Perkins, nothing special.
Well, he had one earlier, catch and finish around the basket. The last one, he got fouled. He had enough time to gather and get it in the hole.
Boy, Garnett has been a monster on the boards in the first 4 minutes. Pierce, catch a three! Paul Pierce lighting it up to start. And the Celtics lead by 8. Timeout, Cavaliers.
And what are the Celtics doing early? Putting the ball in the hands of Paul Pierce offensively. Rolling on an 8-0 run, and it starts and finishes with Paul Pierce. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
The 2008-88 playoffs on ABC, brought to you by GMC, we are professional grade. And Miller Lite, the perfect combination of taste and refreshment.
Welcome back to Boston. Celtics off to a good start. They got a little speech from Doc Rivers before the game.
You got to dominate the glass tonight. You know that, all right? We got to dominate the glass. Every possession counts. We can't take one of those off, you know, and think it'll make up. That might be the difference. Trust your system, guys. Trust your teammates. But most importantly, trust yourselves, all right?
Dominating the glass, so important, because in game six, that's where the Cavs really was able to take control. They're a great offensive rebounding team. One of the reasons they miss more shots than most people. They don't have a high field goal percentage, so more opportunities, but they do take advantage of those opportunities.
Well, I like what Dr. Biss said, that, hey, what we've been preaching all season long, it mattered in game one. It does not change. Game one of the season, that is. It does not change since it's game seven. Continuing to do the things that we've done all season long.
Shot clock winding down. Pierce badgering LeBron James, makes him take a bad shot, but Perkins touches it out of bounds, and they'll get a new 24. And when Doc Rivers first came here in Boston, he was obviously befriended by the late Red Auerbach, and Auerbach was a wonderful mentor to him. One of the things he told him was, keep it simple. Don't complicate things. And Rivers always remembers that, especially in a big game seven like this, where sometimes you don't want to overanalyze and throw too much at the players, Jeff.
I agree with that. The simpler, the better in the playoffs, particularly in closeout situations like this one is for both teams.
James looking to post up Pierce. Excellent defense from Pierce again. Makes him take another difficult shot. Here's Rondo. Coast to coast. Back pass for Pierce. Blocked by Ilgauskas. And it's still going to be Celtic ball. Doc Rivers wanted another foul. Pierce feeling he's getting hit on some of these.
Almost 6 minutes into this ball game, it's been Paul Pierce has been the best player on both ends of the floor, offensively, but also, more importantly, as Coach touched on, defensively, making life tough for LeBron.
Garnett, and that won't count. Perkins with a moving screen, and the Celtics turn it over. You know, we talked so much about the road difficulties through the playoffs and certainly in this series, but the Cavs have had a couple of decent performances here in Boston. Game one, they were right there, had a chance to win it. Game five here in Boston, they were up 14 in the first half. Perkins knocks it away. Ilgauskas gets it back. It's going to be a jump ball. And once again, it's like a rugby scrum if you fall down on the floor. Anything goes. Perkins and LeBron James exchanging some words.
Well, this is game seven. If the ball hits the floor, what are you going to do? Watch. Perkins says, no, I'm going to jump in there. I'm going to be aggressive. Comes up with a jump ball against Ilgauskas.
And here's an important note. And Jeff, you talk about this a lot. You've got to, obviously, it's an emotional game, but you have to control it. And in game seven, you don't want to be decided by a guy getting a technical, and then you lose by one.
Exactly. John Chaney, the former Temple coach, had the best line. You don't want to play emotionally drunk. You've got to be intense and passionate, but also poised.
James, tough move, won't go down. Ben Wallace can't grab it. Here comes Rondo. Three on two. Rondo to Pierce. Perfect timing on the pass.
Pitch a perfect fast break. Rondo with the ball in the middle. Wings filling the lane, and he delivers it right on point, on time to Pierce.
Garnett knocking that out of bounds. We mentioned the late Red Auerbach, who passed away back in October of 2006. He would have loved to watch Kevin Garnett in a Celtic uniform. Always said that that type of player is the one that Red Auerbach loved. Unselfish, hardworking, defensive-oriented.
Now, watching on SportsCenter, Bill Russell, the great Celtic center, doing a one-on-one with Garnett. You can just sense how much he appreciates the way that this man conducts himself on and off the basketball.
Rondo off to an excellent start. Three assists, three rebounds. Perkins, tough shot, almost went in, even though Ilgauskas got a hand on it. Last two games, LeBron James shooting up to 44% after the dismal start. Garnett tips it out of LeBron James's hand. Pierce gets inside. And a jump ball